We are so excited to have almost 200 students on stage, behind the scenes, and in the pit. It has been such a long and difficult 2 years to get theater back to this point, and we are so excited to share this wonderful show with you. Just a few quick reminders. Please make sure that you turn off your phones or put them on airplane mode. These interfere with our mics. Also, there will be no flash photography or videos. This violates our license agreement. Finally, please make sure that you keep clear of our aisles. We are using them as part of our staging. Before we begin, we would like to extend a special thank you to Mrs. Arthurs, Ms. Thomas, Mr. Persia, Ms. Gina, Ms. Common, Ms. Skotek, Ms. Lyons, and Ms. Rock for all of their wonderful help and support. We would also like to thank Bob Sanderson, the High School and Central Administration, and all of our wonderful parent volunteers who helped make the show very well on the web. We would like to take this opportunity to promote our summer theater camp. If you're interested, there is more information on GVPAA.org. Also, we respectfully recommend that you wear your mask for the duration of the show, in our 15-minute intermission, and in the lobby. This helps keep our youngest and oldest audience members safe, as well as our cast and crew. Also, there will be canning for our organization, Minithon, which supports pediatric cancer in the hallway. If you're interested in donating, there'll be canning. Quick reminder that it is common theater etiquette to remain in the theater until after curtain call is over. And without further ado, please sit back, relax, and enjoy Sound of Music.
Oh, no. Keep pulling apart. instead of a battle. I'm grateful to you. Maria, I would like to talk to you.
Yes, about last night. Reverend Mother, I was on my knees most of the night because I was late. And after you had been so kind and given me permission to leave and...
It wasn't about you being late, Maria.
Well, I must have awakened half the abbey before Sister Buckmother heard me and opened the gate.
Very few of us were asleep. You could only think you had lost your way and to be lost at night on that mountain.
But I couldn't be lost on that mountain. That's my mountain. I was brought up on it. It was the mountain that brought me to you. When I was a little girl, I used to come down the mountain, climb up a tree, look over into your gardens. I'd see the sisters on their way to work and hear them sing on their way to the schools. And many a night I'd climb back up the mountain singing all the way. And that brings up another transgression. I was singing yesterday, and I was singing without your permission.
Maria, it is only here in the abbey that there's a rule about singing.
And that's the hardest rule of all for me. Sister Margaret is always reminding me, but too late. I've already started singing.
And the day you were in the garden singing at the top of your voice?
But Mother, it's that kind of song.
I came to the window, and when you saw me, you stopped.
Yes. It's been on my mind ever since.
It's been on my mind, too. I wished you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song when I was a child, and I can't quite remember.
Children,
you
children live. Children are very good with them. They need a governess until September.
Until September?
Captain Lontrap expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man and a great one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal by the Emperor. It was for heroism in the Adriatic.
Captain in the Navy? Oh, Mother, he'll be very strict.
You're not being sent to his bench. God bless you.
Show them I'm worthy, and once more, then I'd show me. So.
was calling the housekeeper and she didn't answer. Do you know why?
Sometimes she doesn't hear, sir.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. I was answering the telephone. Good day, sir. We're happy to have you home again.
Why did the last governess leave?
Who knows? She just said, I've had enough of Easton. Walked out.
Why? Was Louisa playing tricks again? Putting toes in her bed?
She didn't complain of that, sir.
Well, there's a new one coming today, and this one cannot walk out. She is coming from Nonvergadi with orders to stay until September.
And I hope you'll be at home for a time, sir.
Just until tomorrow. The telephone, is it for me?
No, sir, it's for Franz. But before you arrived, there was a call from Vienna. Frau Schrader, I have the number you
gave. I know the number. I'll be back in about a month with some guests.
Do you know how many, sir?
Just two. Herr Detweiler.
Ah, Herr Detweiler.
And Frau Schrader.
Who wanted me on the telephone?
It's the post office. They've got a telegram for you. It will be delivered at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock? That gives me 5 hours to be nervous.
Well, that's scatterbrained boy delivering telegrams.
Well, that's one thing they're saying. If the Germans did take over Austria, we'd have questions.
Don't let the captain hear you say that. He didn't whistle for us when his wife was alive.
He's being the captain of the ship again.
He can't bear being whistled for. It's humiliating.
In the Imperial Navy, the boatswain always whistled for us.
Well, I wasn't in the Imperial Navy.
Too bad. Would have made a fortune.
I'm Captain Von Trapp. You are Fraulein...
Maria. Maria Rainey.
Now, Fraulein, as to your duties. Would you mind stepping over there? We'll put on another dress before the children meet you.
But I haven't any other dress. So we enter the Abbey, while our little clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
The poor didn't want this one.
This is what you would call a worldly dress.
Belonged well as postulant. I would have made myself a dress, but I hadn't. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you were given some material. Today, possibly. Now, you'll be in charge of my children. There are 7 of them. You'll see how far they've progressed in their studies, and go from there. Each morning will be spent in the classroom. Each afternoon, they march. You'll see that they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule of this house is discipline.
Yes, sir.
See how well you listened.
What I mean is, I'll be with them all the time.
Not on all occasions. This is a large house in a large estate. They've been taught to only come when they hear their signal. Now, what I want to do is what you'll hear.
You won't have to trouble, sir. Because I can answer to you in a whistle.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
This is my orderly, my butler, the new governess, Fraulein Maria.
Yes, sir.
The executive officer, Frau Schmidt, the housekeeper. Fraulein Maria, please be sure to have her room ready.
Yes, sir.
Well, time will leave you with the children. And we're in command.
Thank you. You are using up three notes on one word.
Yes, well, sometimes we do that. All together and when you
on an empty stage for fate to turn.
captain is going to run it tomorrow. I have this material for your room for a new dress for you.
How nice of him. Even before it's made, this is the most beautiful dress I've ever had. I hope the captain's going to like it, because I'm going to ask him for more material.
More?
Oh, not for me, for the children, for my clothes.
The bomb trap children never play. The captain doesn't like to be a dirty.
But they're children. They have to roll around in the grass and climb trees and think of all the rocks and
cave. Captain says the best exercise is marching. The children will continue to march. Hope you find your room.
Yes.
Thank you. The window curtains hung before the window and the alcove. They'll be hung tomorrow.
But these curtains are very good.
There will be new curtains. I don't suppose the captain will be away.
No.
There you go. Of course, they have to come home and become tired of the governess. Sometimes I think the children get rid of their governess just to see their father.
I'm sure he wants to see them too.
His buttons out of their mind too much. Oh, you can put this away. You won't be using it.
Why not?
The captain won't have music here.
He won't have music?
He used to love music. It would be wonderful if he was here. His wife would sing, he'd play the violin and the guitar. But he shut all that out of his life.
So that's why he is the way he is. But to not have music, that is wrong for him and wrong for the children.
It may work out. How to marry him before summer's over.
Change. They may have a mother.
It's raining.
Yeah.
We just wanted to make sure you were.
Was this your idea, Friedrich?
Oh, no. Here's Kurt.
Kurt! That's the one! That's the boy I looked at. God bless Kurt. Well, the lightning says something to the thunder, and then the thunder answers back. Maybe if we sing loud enough, nobody will hear it. Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleighbells and shinsu and noodles, wuggies and black and the moon on their bones. These are
no sign of the children, Franz?
No, not yet, sir.
Yes, they're not like any other mountains. They're friendly. Look, see that green stretch of woods over there? When the wind blows through it, it's like a restless sea.
And that sweet little village.
That's not a village. That's a town.
Oh? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt its feelings.
It's unbeaten to you. Quite an experience for me.
Quite an experience for me, too.
You know, somewhere in you, there's a fascinating man. Occasionally I catch a glimpse of him. Well, I do. It's exciting.
Exciting? I've never been called exciting before.
You know, you're a little like those mountains. Except that you keep moving. How can you bear to be away from this place as much as you are?
Perhaps I have been searching for a reason to come back to stay.
Well, I like it here very much.
Max can't still be telephoning. I know he is desperate to find singers for the Clawsburg Festival, but you like it here?
We have to spend some time in Vienna. I have my next estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is, and I'm the president.
You? President of the corporation?
Well, I managed Hyman's affairs for years before we died.
I just can't see you sitting behind the desk.
Of course. I wear a business suit and I smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, Captain. Her grandmother would like his coffee.
While he's telephoning?
He just finished.
I'm sorry I took so long.
Anyone?
How would you like this? For the Clawsburg Festival, the finest cold group in all of Austria, the greatest mixed quartet in all of Europe, and the best soprano in the entire world.
That's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. All I've gotten up to now is a basso who isn't even profundo.
Max, you always come up with good festival concert.
And why? Because my motto is, never start out looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Paris, Rome, Stockholm, London.
On Georg's telephone.
How else could I afford it? Why am I up here?
I had hoped it was because you liked me.
Georg, of course I like you. You live like a king. Excellent wine cellar.
Max.
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official, Georg, is there a cathedral around here?
Yes, our abbey. Thornburg Abbey.
Good. In the next few days, I'll take a visit to all these towns around here and listen to Zendermans, choirs, quartets.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. It was in a town in Nam. That sounds. Watsman, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1930, they won the festival, became very famous, toured all over the world.
Yes, whatever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Say, Georg, who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Rumpelstiltskin?
The Baron Albrecht, the oldest family in the valley.
I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all your friends. Georg, why don't you hold a dinner for me while I'm here? Nothing very much, just something lavish.
I don't know who to invite. It's difficult today to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
Now's not a very good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what has happened to the children.
You're not worried about them,
are you? Well, they were supposed to be here to walk me.
Well, it couldn't be an intentional slap, but they haven't met me yet.
Forgive me.
I'll go find him.
Elsa! I haven't made up Caleb's mind yet. Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes. Although, he hasn't admitted yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
And you don't know what that is.
No.
I do.
What?
It's very simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes, Elsa. He's rich. And you're rich. In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle. Garrett roams away and stands the lovers, still and snuggle. The famous former's fortunes, which they seem to have no fear of. The lovers who are very rich, you very seldom hear of.
There's not a sign of them anywhere.
He's just a boy.
And I hide my Austrian. I will not hide it.
Georg, why don't you look at things the way I do? What's going to happen will happen. Just make sure it doesn't happen to you.
Max! It's a good thing you haven't any character. Because if you had, I am sure I'd hate you.
No! You couldn't hate me. You're too lovable.
There's a call for you.
It's hard. I'll take it!
Thank you.
have forgotten. To laugh like a brook when it shreds and falls over stones in its way. To sing.
Hey, you're the new. Oh, hi.
weren't sure of his success. I'm here.
Max!
Elsa! Adopted the most beautiful corporation president in the entire world.
Thank you, Max.
Max, you're back. And, as usual, just in time for dinner.
Kenlock, did you really think you could throw a gala without me?
Oh dear, now we have an odd man.
Yes, a little odd.
But charming.
Please, Owen. Let us ask Frau Schmidt to set two more places. And I want to see Fräulein Maria.
Two places.
Oh, the head of the woman.
Oh, Liesel?
Oh, no. She is much too young. Not for you.
You're not serious.
But of course.
She's a nursemaid.
I don't think of her that way.
Look, I don't mind other guests. Can't ask them to dine with Maria.
Why not?
Well, so tell me why not.
Yes, Max, please.
Frau Schmidt, they're talking much about there.
Come on, Gail, I've been dodging these people for an hour.
Brigitte, have you seen your father?
Good evening, Fräulein Maria.
Good evening, Adela. It's nice to see you again.
Yes, they're going to.
I knew it all along. Frau Schmidt didn't have a headache. She just wanted to get out of the party she was making.
Now, Brigitte, you know you shouldn't say things you don't know are true.
But I do know. I heard her say to father that she'd been dodging these people.
But that doesn't mean she didn't have a headache. It's important that you like Frau Schmidt.
I like her, all right, why is that important?
Well, because I think she's going to come. I knew her.
Oh, Fräulein, father couldn't marry her. But he couldn't.
Why not?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Brigitte, that's just the kind of thing.
You must know that.
No,
Brigitte. Remember the other night, when we were all sitting on the floor singing the Edelweiss song he taught us? After we finished, you laughed at him for forgetting the words. He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you. And when he speaks to you, the way his voice sounds, and the way you looked at him, just now when you were dancing, you're in love with him.
No, Rita, no.
You must know that.
I know, children.
How about one more dance, and then to bed?
Fräulein Maria, you're not going to have time with the children's kids. You're going to have to have your possible.
It's all right,
but you'll have to hurry. You'll have to change. Where did that dress go the other night?
While we were singing, it was lovely, soft, and
shall I announce dinner, Captain?
Oh, not yet, Franz. The children will want to sing that.
one thing.
Max,
Georg didn't even want them to sing to the party tonight. I had to persuade them.
Ah, then you have influence. You must talk to him.
Max.
Elsa, this is important to Austria. Certainly wouldn't do me any harm.
My life to God's service.
I pledged my life to God.
Maria, if you love this man, it doesn't mean you love God any less. You must go back. You must go.
Go back, Mother. I can't go back. Please don't make me go.
These walls were not meant to shut out your problems, Maria. You have to face them.
Thank you.
Now sing! Seriously! Liesl, give us a key.
Thank you. traitor.
I see. He told us. He taught us himself.
We found him!
Miso?
Miso, you got voice. Hurry up, we'll be in the nurse.
You've come back?
Yes, Captain.
You left us. Without any explanation whatsoever. Not even saying goodbye.
Yes, it was wrong. Forgive me.
Why did you do this to us? Tell me.
Please don't worry. Nevertheless, the reason no longer exists.
So, you're back to stay?
Only until you can make arrangements for another governess.
Oh no, you've been missed by the children. Mm-hmm. I missed everybody. Missed you while you were away. Everything was wrong.
Okay.
We'll talk about it later. Talk to the children now. Maria, a new dress?
You have a new postulant.
I know I'm right, Max. We'll just find him and ask him.
Take your word for it, Elsa.
Georg, settle this for Max and me, will you? How far down the mountain does your property line go?
Can you make out that stone wall? That's the property line.
See?
Didn't argue about it.
I know. And that makes me furious. You see, I can't bear to win without fight.
Hey, Van Wilder. While you were gone, you were long distance call from Berlin. Who could possibly be calling me from Berlin? They said you know who it was.
I'll call it back.
Georg! What were we just talking about?
Max, this isn't your first call from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no political convictions. May I help if other people have?
Let's not stir that up again, please. The Germans have promised not to invade Austria. Max knows this.
Then why does he continue to answer those calls from Berlin?
Because if they don't keep that promise, I'd like to have some friends among them.
Naturally.
Oh. You agree too?
Georg, this is the way I look at it. There was a man who was dying. We were giving him the last rites, and they said, do you renounce the devil and all his works? And he said, at this moment, I prefer not to make any enemies.
Georg, if they should invade, would you defy them?
Yes. But do you know what happened to you? To your property?
To your children?
To everyone close to you? To Elsa? To me.
Well, what would you do?
What anyone with any type of common sense would do. Sit tight and wait for it all to blow over.
And you think it will?
One thing's for sure. Nothing you do will make any difference.
Don't look so serious, darling. Take the world off your shoulders. Relax.
You dear, attractive, dewy-eyed idealist. Don't dare have to learn to be a realist.
You may be bent on doing deeds of daring do, but our book gets the sharp one cannot carry do.
Be wise, compromise.
Compromise and be wise.
Let them think you're on their side, be non-committal.
I will not bow my head to the men I despise.
Won't have to bow your head, just stoop a little.
Why not learn to put your faith and your reliance on an obvious and simple fact of science?
can agree. Each one is important to himself. You don't save yourself by just giving up. You can't up your life by putting your head into your call from Merlin, sir. The lion's mouth.
Call them back, Franz.
Might as well talk to them now.
Yes, go. Go. Go.
Leord, I feel I know what's going to happen here. Can't you see things my way?
No. Not if you're willing to see things their way.
No. There's one thing you do better here than in Vienna. The sunsets. I'm going to miss them.
Captain! Oh, I beg your pardon.
Oh, yeah. Georg, you didn't tell me Fraulein Marie's back. I'm delighted.
Yes. Well, Captain, the children would like to know if they can go on a picnic tomorrow.
Yes, I don't mind.
I'll make them very happy. And may I also be permitted to wish you happiness, Frau, Captain? The children told me you're going to be married.
The children told you wrong. Hey, Olga, I've got to finish packing if I'm to get back to Vienna.
If you feel you must, I'll tell Franz to have the car ready.
I can do that.
Maria, your whole life is about to change. I'll take you anywhere you want to go. Give you anything you want.
But I don't wish to go. All I can wish for is right here.
Thank you. somewhere in my room. Poor child, I must have done something good.
Nothing comes from nothing, nothing at all. So somewhere in my room,
poor child,
I'm not happy, but no.
Luisa, Kurt, Brigitte, Marta, and Gro.
Why am I always last? Because
you're the youngest.
Now, Weasel, I'm depending on you. Day after tomorrow, you must have all the children ready at 11 o'clock.
Herr Detweiler, can you help me, please? The Gauleiter is here. He wants to know why we aren't allowed in the new class.
Hi.
I tried to explain.
Keep quiet! When will Captain Von Trapp be returning? Who knows? Man is on his honeymoon. This is no time for joking! It's been 4 days since the Anschluss, and this is the only house in the province that's not by the flag of the Third Reich.
You mean the flag with the black spider on it?
Brigitte, do you permit such remarks in this household? Who are you?
I am Maximilian Detweiler, First Secretary of the Culture and Education.
That was a part of the old regime. The old regime, I was Third Secretary. Now I'm First. Good. Then you shall order them to fly the flag.
The captain wouldn't. I can only take my orders directly from Captain Von Trapp.
You shall take orders from us! And that includes the captain. Hi.
Hi.
Let us at least be grateful for that. sing in the festival, it'll be a bad reflection on Austria. It certainly wouldn't do me any good.
Maria, I've always known you loved us children. Now I know you love father. But I love him very much. How can you be sure?
Well, I don't think first of myself anymore. I think first of him. I now know how to spend my life.
I didn't think I'd have to face a decision this soon.
Safe. But then that would mean
Maria, please help me.
Gail, whatever you decide will be my decision.
Thank you. I know that I can't do it.
Of course not.
We have to get out of Austria right away.
We have to get out now. Tonight, now.
Not without my family. We can't just get up and leave. They'll be watching us now. We have to make a plan. We have to make time.
Heil! Sir Admiral von Schreiber of the Navy of the Third Rank is here to see you.
Thank you, Franz. Didn't give us time.
We'll make time.
I'll go out them in. We have to be careful.
Thank you.
shining children.
Thank you. Regretfully they tell us, but firmly they command.
to. The Zengerbund of Hergoin.
Thank you. Thank you.